One of the things that I see a lot of women doing wrong, and this is not personal clients, this is like seeing women in the mall, seeing women in the restaurant, seeing women walking down the street, and they'll pull out a compact powder and they will literally take the puff that it comes with. Hey there, fellow beauty finders, it's mathias4makeup, and thank you so much for clicking on this week's video. On my brand new series, Beauty Bullet Tips, I'm gonna be going over some really short and precise beauty advice. I've been teaching here on YouTube for almost 10 years, and I've been a working professional makeup artist for over 20. And I've learned so much about makeup artistry through doing this on women of all ages, nationalities, and skin tones. And I can honestly say that my YouTube channel, which showcases all of these types of women, is the most inclusive and diverse out of all the YouTube channels out there. But in my new YouTube series, Beauty Bullet Tips, I'm gonna just give you some really quick pro makeup artist tips and advice. These are gonna be really short and to the point, easy to digest, capsule-sized videos so that you can kind of just get your feelings wet. These are gonna be some really easy to digest and watch capsule-sized videos showcasing some of my favorite pro makeup artist tips and tricks every single week. Okay, so in this week's episode, we're gonna be talking about touching up your skin with powder if you tend to show a little bit of shine after a few hours. One of the things that I see a lot of women doing wrong, and this is not personal clients, this is like seeing women in the mall, seeing women in the restaurant, seeing women walking down the street, and they'll pull out a compact powder and they will literally take the puff that it comes with and they'll go back into the powder like so, and they'll swipe very strongly, get a lot of powder on it, and they'll start swiping down their face, almost like pulling their skin down. Now, if it's a powder foundation, this is especially rough on your skin because powder foundation is gonna have coverage in it. Kind of like MAC Studio Fix. Not a lot of people realize that even though that's been around for like 25 years, that is actually powder and foundation in one. It was designed so that people didn't have to do primer and foundation and concealer and then set it with powder. They just wanted something quick and easy. And MAC was amazing to do that. I think it was the first of its kind. This is a pressed powder called Bye Bye Pores from IT Cosmetics. So this is more translucent and invisible. But I can honestly tell you that if I were to take this much powder and swipe it across my dewy, moist skin, what it's gonna do is it's gonna just really collect and sit there really heavy, and it's going to look chalky, especially if I'm putting it on an oily complexion, because wherever there's moisture on the face, powder is gonna stick to and it's gonna get a little bit darker. So rather than use the puff that it comes with, I'm gonna actually recommend that you take a powder brush with you in your purse. Now, they make small ones of these, they make travel size powder brushes, something that's a little bit easier to carry, but I would recommend taking your powder and lightly dusting and tapping the powder from the brush into the T-zone like so. It's going to create a much softer, finer look. It's gonna look more airbrushed. It's not gonna look as heavy. It's not gonna look cakey. And you're still gonna get a softer, more matte finish, but it's not gonna look as heavy and it's gonna look much more realistic. And then that's it. And that's how you can refresh your look. And I hope you enjoyed this kind of like quick beauty bullet tip, because it is essential to consider that no makeup is gonna stay perfect for the whole day until you take it off. As always, I hope you enjoyed this week's video. I would love to hear your comments and thoughts in the comment section down below. I love hearing from my Beauty Finder squad here on YouTube. And you being interactive with me here on YouTube helps me to create more content that you are dying to see. So please, please, please do be interactive. Click thumbs up on this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking on that little box right down there at the bottom if you haven't done so already. As always, I would also love for you to follow me on all my social media at mathias4makeup, including Facebook, where I do a live Q&A every single week. I hope you're staying safe and healthy and loving your friends and your family and the strangers amongst you just the same. Remember to find the beauty within. And until I see you next, have a beautiful day. Bye for now.